Hello again, folks. Welcome to another edition of Between the Banks. I'm Bob Goose. Now, if you remember last edition, y'all had to leave, but I stayed. And let's see, am I going to open up with another cat? Yes, I am. Just like last show. But if you tuned in last show, you know I hammered the Specks. And I ended up, my last fish was a really nice one. So, they were all nice. I didn't have to measure. Stay tuned. I'm still fishing in the East Access Canal. Hopefully my luck is going to stay just like it was last show. And I'm going to be able to finish out my limit of speckle trout. Stay tuned. We'll see what happens. It's another Rock'em Sock'em edition of Between the Banks. Stick with us.
Between the Banks is brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Louisiana.
My name is Somesh Nigam, and I'm the Chief Analytics and Data Officer for Blue Cross. Our job is to find interesting insights that truly can make a difference in a member's life. We can predict diabetes before diabetes happens, hospitalization before hospitalization happens, apply interventions to slow down the progression of disease, to provide for a more healthful life. And I feel that that makes our job really worthwhile.
Up and down the bayou. That's how we tell you to get from one place to the other. It's a little different, but so are we in Louisiana's Cajun Bayou. And once you get here, you'll understand why our Cajun runs a little deeper. Find a piece of our story on swamp tours, fishing boats, at festivals, attractions, and restaurants. Visit lacajunbayou.com to plan your trip today. Louisiana's Cajun Bayou. Rich, natural, unapologetically Cajun. Just south of New Orleans, where Cajun runs deep.
Melico Sisters are located north of Walmart on Highway 3235. Stop in for all your hardware needs. Fishing tackle, both inshore and offshore. Camping gear, camping supplies, and camper parts, safety, tools, hardware, all can be found at Melico Sisters Hardware and Supply.
It's a trout. Oh, it is. It's a whitey. Fat white trout. Who really inhaled them. That's one thing good about the East Access Canal. You can catch specks, big specks like you saw last edition. And you can also catch a nice mess of white trout. That was on the gunwale line. Again, what I'm doing here in the East Access Canal is I've anchored on the 6-foot ledge that comes off the bank and drops off into the canal. I got my power pole stuck right there. And I'm casting to the middle. If you look back, you can see we got a little slick that's running right down the middle of the canal here. Close to the boat, you can see right here where all the white bubbles are. Big old slick. Dead giveaway that there's fish here. And you can see how far I have anchored from the big cut right there, too. So, really good fishing spot here. So, here's another white trout for the box. Take this off, and when I come back, I'm going to show you how I've got my Carolina rigs that I've got in the gunwale, how I've got them rigged. Stay tuned. Let us back.
Oh, yeah. That was Specks. Another keeper trout. Okay, so I'm going to throw this fish in the box, and then I'm going to show you how I got that butter rigged here. I say everybody, me. Another trout for the box. Stay tuned. I'll show you how I got everything rigged here when I come back. Stick. All right, folks. So when I come to East Access Canal, I anchor on that 6-foot drop-off where it goes to the middle of the canal. And I cast the line out into the middle of the canal where the oysters are thickest. And I cast one out on the other side. And I put them in the gunwale of the boat. I don't touch them. I leave them there. Now, the way I rig my Carolina rig, I show it to you all the time. Here's a small kale hook on a 25-pound test shock leader. Now, this is a short suicide shock leader here. The reason this is so short is because if the fish are tapping it lightly, like they tend to do during the winter time, you can feel the hit. I've got the shock leader coming through a 1/8 ounce barrel weight once, then twice, just so I can keep it pegged. And then I've got a black crane swivel up at the top. I'm using live cockahoes. I got these from Gail's Bait Shop. I run it through the lips of the cockahoe, the tissue between the lips and the skull. I pass it through right there. I cast it out to the middle of the canal, and then I just put it in the gunwale rod holder on each side of the boat. Two of those lines are rigged on spinning gear. This is a Daiwa combo 7-foot medium action rod with a 30 or a 40 class Daiwa spinning reel. I always use spinning reels in my gunwale rods. My other three rods that I have, two Calcuttas and an Akuma combo, are all bait casters. And what I do is, since I've got these two lines spread out, I take my artificial lines. One has a DOA shrimp on it, one has a sheepdog on it, and the other's got a finger mullet type lure on it. So that's how I'm casting. That's how I've got all of this rigs you can get over at Bellico Sisters. They've got it right there on the 4-lane as you come into Galliana. They're located on the right. Complete hardware, you ought to see. Really awesome store. Stop in, check them out. They're the official Between the Banks tackle sponsor where I get all my gear at. Bellico Sisters, right there on the 4-lane, right before you hit Walmart on the right as you head south. So that's how I rig. All the rigs that I've got on the boat are 7-foot medium action rods. There you go. I'm gonna cast this out, see if we can get a little fish on. Stay tuned. This one feels like it's got a little weight to it. Bite time today was from 9 to 11 o'clock. And then the tide's going to slack down after that. It's a nice fish. Oh, it's a trout. Nice trout. I'm living dangerously now. I'm swinging them in. The one thing about trout, a lot of people say, oh, wintertime, redfish. And I've got nothing against redfish, but if you've watched Between the Banks through the years, you know I like to hunt trout. Now, this is a male. I can feel him just croaking away. Right in the middle on the Carolina rig on the gunwale.
All right, I'm gonna put this in the box and we're gonna throw it back out there again. Stay tuned. Part two of fishing the East Access Canal. Stick with us. They're hitting that gunnel line big time. The first one that we turned the male croaking away. Let's see, gotta be 12 inches now, folks. When you fish speckled trout, gotta be 12 inches, and you can have 25 specks. White trout, no limit. Take as many as you want, whatever size you want. This one, 11 inches, turn them back. So, that's what's going on. Again, the East Access is a favorable place because you've got big bushes on both sides. I know you can see it in the background, both sides. So if I get a north to east wind blowing, I'm going to anchor up on that north bank and be protected because of those high bushes. On a south wind, I'm going to anchor on the south bank. And that way, when I cast, I'm casting with the wind at my back so I can feel the lines and I can put them in the gunnel and they'll still be able to get the hit. But real important. Now, one other thing I need to tell you. If you remember from the last edition, we were filming here on the 21st of November. So, if you look at the tide chart, you'll notice I'm coming in the new moon, but I've got a slack tide. So another reason why I picked the East Access Canal, because I got wind blowing right down the East Access Canal. Oh, looks like I got a hit on the other line. Let me go get it. Stay tuned. Feels like a trout. Shaking his head. Feels like I got a little weight to him, too. Boy, that gunnel really works well. Just pull it out of that gunnel holder and set the hook. Trout. Oh, big white trout or is that a speck? Oh, that's a keeper speck. Keeper speck. And I'm going to tell you something, folks. When you feel the fish, they're warm. So they're down there in that deeper water. Remember, water temperature during the winter time. The warmer water is the deeper water. The complete opposite in the summertime. The deeper water is the cooler water. So, speckled trout are definitely temperature oriented. So, that's why you've got to work canals with deeper water and concentrate on the middle of the canals. And if you find canals with oysters like we have in the East Access Canal, you're in heaven. Just pull your boat up, anchor up, like I was telling you, put out your gunnel lines, and just sit there and enjoy yourself. And when you see the rods bend over, you know it's a trout. Stay tuned. Cut. I could do it. It's a trap. Another keeper. Swinging him in. Okay. On that little short suicide line. Suicide line. Whenever fish get tentative or it's winter time,
and you're fighting the elements, remember, shorten that leader up to about 6 to 8 inches like this. And I call it a suicide leader. You'll feel the hits a lot easier with that shorter leader. Same weight, same hook, just a short shot leader. Try that out, you'll see it'll help you out, especially when conditions get to where they're just mouthing the bait, you can barely feel it. It's a little trick that I use on one of the lines that are in the gunwale on the side of the boat. So, keep that in mind. It works real good, produces specks. Another trout. They're wearing me out here now. Is a catfish. Well, there you go. Just gotta wade your way through the catfish. I know they're undesirables, but like I said on the last edition, once that water temperature hits 55 and drops down below that, the catfish are gonna go dormant and you won't even be plagued with catfish. I'm gonna flip him off and get back out there. Stay tuned. Running like a speck. Feels like a good fish, too. Feels like a good... I'm telling you, this East Access Canal, if it's winter time, this is where I'm going. The keeper speckled trout in the East Access Canal. Now, don't worry, folks. I know I'm doing a two-part series out of here, but there are other places that you catch big specks during the winter time. Bayou Lafourche, the South Texaco Field. I'm going to tell you about the South Texaco Field when I come back. I'm gonna knock out some myths about if you come to Leeville, there's no water to fish because it's all private and everything else. That's the biggest crock. I'm gonna tell you right where you can fish, and there's plenty spots, and it's loaded with fish. And you're not gonna get run off if you go there. So, East Access is one of those places. All the places that I fish are all legal spots. I've never been run off out of a spot since I've been fishing Leeville. Never. So, stay tuned. Oh, getting a hit on the other line. Stick with us. The action's hot and heavy. All hell's breaking loose now. Another one. All keeper specks, with the exception of one. Everything we've caught have been keepers, minus the two catfish. And this is a cat. It's all right. They're here too, and like I say, they'll soon stop biting and we won't have to worry about cats. Okay, so. I promised you I was going to tell you about places that you can fish when you fish Leeville. The South Texaco Field. The borders of the South Texaco Field are Bayou Lafourche, the Southwest Canal, Little Lake, Hackberry, all of that
big, huge square, several thousand acres of marsh. And folks, when you go in the South Texaco field, there's oyster beds everywhere. So you can easily catch a limit of reds there. And you can also catch some really big speckled trout. And I'm gonna show you that in upcoming shows during the winter time. Captain Bob's gonna be in that South Texaco field working the East Canal, the East Pond, all those oyster beds. Now, you gotta learn your way in. But if you go back and look on YouTube, shows that I've done in the South Texaco field, I show you that neck of the woods on the map feature to where you're not gonna tear up your boat going in there or anything like that. Plenty deep water, plenty redfish, plenty specks all year long. I mean all year long. Now, finally, during the winter time, the duck hunters are out and they pay to hunt the marsh. There's no open marsh other than the South Texaco field where you have to worry about duck hunters. So respect the duck hunters. They're only in there for two couple of months. You know, I know there's a lot of boats with pro drives and stuff to where you can get into the marsh. But during the winter time, respect the duck hunters. They pay some serious money to lease that marsh. Okay, I'm gonna get this catfish off and we're gonna get back out there again. Stay tuned. All right, folks, we're coming up to the Marina Minute in the map feature. But I wanted to show you the size of this cockahoe that I got from Gales. I just put it on the line. I'm hoping to catch luck or a fish like I did on the part one right at the end of the show. So I'm gonna cast this out. In the meantime, let's check out the Marina Minute. All the fine businessmen that make your fishing trip to Leeville complete. It starts up in Raceland, G&F Sporting Goods, handles all your Yamaha service, Express aluminum boats, a really nice facility, services, power pole. I mean, really great guys. Go see Eric and his family. Great people. Then come on down to Highway 90 and LA 1. You got Cajun Bayou Tourist Commission. You can stop in there. They'll tell you just what's going on in the parish, just what's happening. Then head on south. You're coming into Galliano on the right, on the four lane before you hit Walmart. You've got Melico Sisters as you head to south. Hardware, where all my tackle and stuff comes from. Really a great facility. Go check them out. They've got paint, hardware, everything you need for home improvements and for fishing and for honey. All in one big store. Melico Sisters. Then come on down some more. Come into Leeville. You've got bunch of bait shops, got Leeville Seafood Restaurant, great place to eat. Got Griffin's right across from Boudreaux's. All right, folks, here's the map feature brought to you by the great folks at Lowrance. Notice I'm anchored in 6 feet right along that ledge so I can cast out into the middle of the deeper water. Notice how the water temperature is climbing up with the warm weather, 62.5 degrees. And you can see I've got a current of about a tenth of a knot. Now, I'm fishing a flatter tide, but in the East Access Canal, I've got an east wind blowing, so it's driving the water down the canal. And I've got an incoming tide now. So the water's rising. Not a lot of fish along the ledge. Everything's out in the middle.
Let's take a look at the map. Let's go pages, map, enter. Okay, so you can see how close I am to Boudreaux's Waterfront Motel. I came out of Boudreaux's Canal, hit the Southwest Canal, passed in front of the fishing pier, came to Bayou Lafourche. You can see the Leeville public boat launch there, and then came around to the East Canal. When I got to the East Canal, I took the 45 degree angle canal, and I came over to where Five Points is. All these points are great fishing there too. And you always see the bank fishermen over there. They've been there all morning long and they're catching whites and specks and reds over there off the bank. So come on down the East Access Canal right before you get to the first big cut on the right. I'm anchored. Okay, so let's get our coordinates. Okay, so I'm not going to save this because it's the same exact coordinates as they were for last week's map feature. So, the coordinates are north 29, 14, 6, 27, west 90, 12, 138. Since I've got these in there, I'm not going to save. But you can see all of the spots that I've got here along the East Access Canal. You can see this is one of my favorite places. I've got about six or seven spots marked right here in the East Access Canal. So there's the map feature. Let's go see if I've got anything biting on that big old cockahoe that I've got out there. Stay tuned.
Got all the details you need to come in and get I think I got some action going on that big cockahoe. Oh, line's tight. Let it go. We're at the end of our bite. A morning bite. But take the tips that I've given you. East Access Canal, great fishing spot. And the East Access Canal, most people know it because it's the canal you take to go to the boat graveyard back in those areas. Of course, I don't fish that because it's posted property. And like I said, I don't like fishing in areas where people are duck hunting. South Texaco Field, I'll be doing some shows on that, and I've also got a show that we're going to tape at the fishing pier. We'll see you next week with another edition of Between the Banks, probably on the fishing pier. Stay tuned. In the meantime, good luck fishing.